Hello everybody, my name is Phaethodas and here we are once again with Torchlight 2, Jadok, with the critical build, Ice Deep Caverns. It requires level 16-18, or not requires, but it says that you need to be that level if you go to survive easily. This character is level 15, almost 16. Well, let's go inside, who cares. I will go and try to beat this dungeon, to explore it completely and successfully. Chuck. By the way, guys, if you would be interested in having live streams of this playthrough, of this character, and some episodes of this playthrough to be live streaming episodes, leave a comment below, let me know, because we are going to have a streaming schedule from next month, next week actually. And so maybe sometimes I can play this character on live streaming. Oh, that was a tough, a hard hit. What is that? Ice gel? King ice gel. We are killing jellies. Level up. So now I'm level 16. Okay. So this is a critical build, so we have to increase our critical chance, of course our damage too. I have one skill point. Its critical strike heals 5.5% of your maximum health. No. This is very good. Put a point here. Transfers 17% of damage dealt for 8.5 seconds. Chuck. Critical. The bad thing about these enemies is that they slow me down. And I don't like getting slowed down in action RPG games, it is annoying. Come on. Okay. Whoa! Hulking Slasher. Coma Taka. 1 million pieces. Meat pieces. Okay, somehow, for some reason, I feel like I might die inside this place. Of course, this is not a hardcore character, so even if I die, this is not a problem, but I would like not to die. Ice Mangler. Powerful ice attacks. Okay, I'm not afraid of powerful ice attacks, I think. One more jelly. Nice. No, opa. This guy behaves like a bull. Come on. Chuck. Chuck. This is the nice thing about this specific skill. You use it, it hits multiple enemies, and when you hit just one enemy, all of the enemies affected by the skill, they receive damage. So it helps making your basic attack something like an AoE attack. The skill here, the Shadow Bind. Pack is full. La, la. Nothing, nothing. Oh! Do not knock me back, please. This is the most annoying thing about this game. If you haven't played Torchlight games, both the first game and this one, the second, you wouldn't know that here we have too much knockback going on. Especially when the enemies hit you and they knock back you, it is very, very super annoying. And also, you can also knock back enemies. There are many weapons that come with the knockback effect. And it is also very annoying. And this is why some people created mods for these two games. That they take this knockback effect out of the game. Both the first Torchlight and the second. Now, soldiers. Ah, a bat! More bats. Ouch! Whoa, is this a line of blood? Yes, this was blood. Ooh! Too much blood, too much wine. I think this big guy is inside the walls of this cave. Yes, they die. This is how they die. Wow. My pet has fled! Wow! I need to somehow make my pet stronger by using items, of course, pet items. We can equip our pets with items here, 1, 2, 3. I gave my pet two items, but I need to upgrade these items and also give him or give it a third one. This slot is empty now. Yeah. Let's go! Crate! Oh, crate! The creator of Grim Dawn, crate! I'm breaking down crate. Crate, baby, crate. Oh, don't kill me, please. I'm a good guy. Add goblin sack. You destroy the sack and you get gold. Very nice. This sack is very nice. Goblin sack. Nobody here. Nobody here. Mirka's laser. Let's go. We are getting very close to the boss. There is a boss here inside this cave, as you can see here, the Chilhuf. This is another floor, the floor of the boss. So let's go. The sound effect of the fire here is very nice. I like it very much. Progenic. The boss is inside this thing here. Here comes Cloverhoof. Chillhoof. Sorry. My pet has fled. As you can see now, this guy is always knockbacking me. Come on here. Come on here. Critical, critical, yeah. I like critical hits. Come on. Come on, closer to the wall. I got you. Yes, he is dead. Ah, mysterious boots. Unique item. Mana potion, identify scroll. What's that? Ring. After months of research and experiments, I am forced to conclude that my ember blight is incurable. And I am not alone. Hundreds die from it every year. Goodbye. We need to read two more notes. Ah, enemies. This is the second note. Okay, let's go. There is one more to read. Chuck. Don't kill me, please. More enemies. I guess they were hiding here when I was fighting against the boss. Maybe they were afraid. But in the end, they all died. I had to kill them. Portal to the surface. Come on, this game takes a long time to load the game.
Welcome, human.
Welcome, human. I'm not a human, I'm a hero. I am a hero and not a human. Whatever I take is kind of useless. Let's go now. I like very much this area because there is much snow. It is snowing. This area looks great, this map. But it is also a very big map, as we can see. We cannot explore it, of course, in one episode only. Shrine of Speed! Haha, now I run faster. Great news. Wait, nope. This way. What do we have here? Nothing. Nothing. Okay. Rocks. Oh, rocks. Rocks. This is locked. I have to fight the little creature that holds the key for this chest. Nothing here. Yes, level up. Items identified. This is a nice thing about this game. When you level up, if you have items in your inventory, unidentified items, it identifies items automatically because you level up. Come on, let me kill you. I am the destroyer of monsters. Your pack is full. Maybe I should go there. Although I explored that area in the previous episode. No! What? Somebody killed me. Okay. Resurrect in town and lose nothing. Resurrect here but lose 8,000 gold. Resurrect at the entrance to... No, I will resurrect here. You can take my gold away, but you can never kill me. And I'm loose. Oh! Okay, okay, okay. I need to upgrade my equipment. Anybody else? Ah, the boss. Down you go. A dead adventurer. What's that? Waypoint portal. Let's go this way. Discover the Ember Scratch Minehead. Yeah. Now we run. Oh. What did you say? These goblins say some things that you can never understand, actually. Or at least I can never understand. Maybe some of you could understand what they say, but I don't. Ah, a face portal, face beast. Okay. Before I go inside the face portal, I will go back to town and I will sell crappy items.
Have we met?
No, we haven't. Thank you. Goodbye. Ah, this is a set item, but I don't really need it. Unique item. Damage per second, rare claw, 133. Yes, this is very nice. Wait. What's that? Skull of Benzrim. Oh, unique. Unique. Equip it. Yes, sell this one. Gloves. Butch Cloverhoof. It is the same set item, but it comes with different attributes. This is how sets the rare sets work in this game, because we have rare sets and also unique sets, but the rare sets can have different attributes, but unique sets, every time you fight, I don't have a unique item, set item to show you now, I think. But every time you fight a unique set item, if you fight it two times, they will always have the exact same attributes and numbers. Anyway, this looks like an armor upgrade, but I'm not going to use it. Oh. Dexterity. Yeah, this is better. We keep all of these things. So this is Pandaloons, Outladder. I don't want you, engineer, Ebermaids. Outladder. Let me keep this one, maybe. No. Useless. Ebermaids. Keep the socketables. Oh! I also have items to sell in my my pets. Yeah. What? Two-stroke hammer. Ah, I have it twice now. Two pieces plus 30% attack speed. Which means I'm going to be using these two now, so forget about this one. And this one. And this one. And also this one. Nice. Very nice. This was a great fight. What's that? Don't want you. Two-handed weapon. Don't need you. Nobody wants you. Let me identify the items. Yes. What's that? Buffadon Bill's hide mask. No. Shield. I'm not using any shields. This shield is nice though. Physical damage reflected. Sell it. Oh, strength 68, level 21. I will keep this one. I will sell this one and engineer. This is a set item. Okay. We are fine, I think. If I put it there. No, this is worse.
I am at your service.
Yes, you are. Thank you. Goodbye. I have matters to attend to. By the way, sir. No, sir. Stas. Stas. I have only this thing. These two are for level 100. Wow. 99. Okay, let's go back now. And now we are here, this is the face portal. Let's go inside the face portal and explore and see. Ignite the braziers in order. Okay. One. This was wrong. No. You need to activate these things in the right order, which means no. Zack, this is the first one. Now we have to fight which is the second one. Let's go here. Yes! The third. This one. No! So when you hit a wrong thing, brazier, monsters come out and you have to start lighting them up in the correct order from the beginning. 2, 3, 4. This is the challenge. Very easy challenge, of course. It is nothing hard or special or whatever. And here we have a boss. Yes, and now we can see there is too much gold in the ground. Gold, the gold is mine. Mine! And also we get some chests. Gold, gold. This game is loot crazy. Chest. It was a trapped chest. Oh, I need to go and buy potions, by the way. This was this challenge. Okay, so guys, we will stop this episode here and we will continue on the next episode. This journey of this critical build. Now again, if you got me to live stream some of the episodes of the playthrough of this character, leave a comment below, let me know, and I will see you very soon with more videos. Thank you for watching and have fun.